Hi, it's Arne. This video is about trigonometry and I'm going to show you how to find sinus and cosinus using a unit circle. A unit circle is a circle with the radius of 1. I'm using the program Geogebra. It's a free program and it's very easy to use. First I'll find my center of my circle and it's in 0.0. So I'll just write A equals 0, 0, and now I find my point. I could use this tool finding a point, but it'll be the same results. Now I use this point to draw my circle with the radius of 1. Circle with center and radius. Now I just press A and my radius will be 1. Okay, now I got my unit circle. In order to use my unit circle to show how sinus and cosinus works, I'll have to make some make a triangle here, a right-angled triangle. First, I'll have one point. If I press near the circle edge, you can see it lightens up, and this point B will be attached to the circle, like that. Then I have a segment or a line between A and B. I'm using the same names as you would do in Pythagoras' sentence. So this line will be called the hypotenuse. That's a kind of a hard word to say. So it's HIP. Okay, the hypotenuse will have the length of 1 and it will always be 1 long. So I'll press 1 here and you can see the hypotenuse will be have the distance of 1. Then I need to make a right angled triangle using this tool, this line, pressing the B point and the X axis, and I'll have the intersecting point here, the C point. Now I can make the segments between B and C and C and A, and I can turn off my helping line. It was this line. Now I got my right angled triangle. To show it, I'll use my angle tool, and you need to be careful. If you press the other way around, this angle would show it the other way around, and this angle now C, so this is the right angle. Now I can show the two angles in my triangle I'm going to work with. This is the right angle, it's 90 degrees. I can use this move tool to make any right angle triangle that's possible, and you can see this angle will change, but the hypotenuse will stay 1. If I use my distance tool, I'll see that this length will change in a bit and this length will change in a bit. Wait and see. So only these two sides will change. These two sides in a unit circle represents sinus and cosinus. It's quite hard to remember, but this side, it's the co-pilot of the point A. So if I change this, rename this side to cosinus, and press. Then this side will show the cosinus value to this angle. This side is the sinus value. So if I rename this to sinus, this will show the sinus value to this angle. If you need to remember this, it starts with the S side, and it's the opposite side of the angle. every angle have its own side, and this would normally be named A if this is called big A. Okay, so now I can draw this, and I have a sinus and cosinus calculator. I'll find a point I know the value of. It's 45 degrees. It's quite hard to close enough. Then these values should be the same, because this angle and this angle should be the same. I'll just have the angle, and the angle is more or less the same. So the sides are the same now. In order to use this, you need to know the rules of similitude. The rules of similitude shows that if you have two triangles and the angles are the same, then the sides would be relative to each other. So if this side will be, for example, 7 times greater, then this side is also 7 times greater, and this side is also 7 times greater. So I've drawn another circle, another triangle here. This triangle has the side, the hypotenuse is 7. So this side should be 7 times as great as my other triangle here. I'll just put in the numbers, a second here and here. So this is more or less 5. I'll have my calculator using the sinus, so 45 degrees sinus, it's 0.7, it's the same as my other calculator here, 0.71, so it's the same in my calculator. I'll multiply by 7, so it's 4.95, and it's the same as my drawing, 4.95. I could take this value and multiply that by 7, and it will be the same result. So this is a dynamic calculator for showing sinus and cosinus. Thank you for watching.